molecules. A quick definition.
Carbon, a common element that forms organic compounds. It combines with other elements such as hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. Macromolecules are very long molecules. Examples include proteins and polymers. All are composed of hundreds or thousands of atoms.
So why does this matter?
Carbon is the starting point for all life.
And those macromolecules?
And when carbon starts bonding with its friends, nitrogen, phosphorus, oxygen, sulfur, and hydrogen,
life is possible because these compounds like to get together in all shapes and sizes. When a few hang out, they are known as monomers. When we string a bunch of monomers together, we get polymers.
Carbon macromolecules are the foundation of life.
Life starts with the cheeseburger. The cheeseburger includes all the ingredients needed for life. The cheeseburger includes the four main ingredients needed for life, which include carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, nucleic acid. That cheeseburger has a bun. That bun is made up of carbohydrates, you know, sugars. Sugars make all life possible.
Plants convert the sun's energy into a useful form through the process of photosynthesis.
Glucose is the sugar that is created when plants convert the sun's energy into a useful form.
Sugars come in all shapes and sizes. Some of the better known ones include glucose, lactose, and fructose.
One that you might be familiar with is high fructose corn syrup. High fructose corn syrup is a sweetener that is used in a bunch of foods that comes from corn.
In animals, carbohydrates provide the energy they need to survive. In plants, cellulose, a type of plant fiber or sugar, helps to provide strength and rigidity.
Sugars are carbohydrates. And now, back to that cheeseburger.
On that cheeseburger, the meat and cheese contain lipids.
Lipids are also known as fats.
Lipids help store energy, make up part of the cell membrane, and act as one type of hormone which helps regulate parts of the body.
There are two types of fats. Remember, fats help store energy.
Saturated fats. Saturated fats typically come from food that includes animal fats and processed foods. Saturated fats will be solid at room temperature. Saturated fats are also saturated with hydrogen atom. Unsaturated fats. Unsaturated fats typically come from vegetable sources. Examples include cooking oils such as corn, sesame, and peanut oils. Unsaturated fats will be in a liquid state at room temperature. They have a double bond with a fatty acid chain and are missing a hydrogen atom. This means they are not saturated.
Different types of hormones. Hormones regulate many activities in a body. There are two types of hormones. There are water-soluble and fat-soluble.
Fat-soluble hormones come from cholesterol, a type of lipid. Examples include testosterone, progesterone, and estrogen.
Lipids are also part of the cell membrane.
Lipids help make up part of the cell membrane. The cell membrane protects the cell from everything outside of it.
And now, back to that cheeseburger.
That cheeseburger contains protein, one of the building blocks for life.
Protein. Everything in your body is made of proteins. They keep you living.
Proteins start off as monomers.
There are 20 amino acids in the human body that make up millions of proteins.
Proteins regulate your body.
Proteins are the antibodies that fight off diseases.
Yes, muscles are made from proteins.
And yes, hair is made from protein.
Amino acids bond together with a peptide bond to make a long chain.
Twist these long chains together and fold them,
and you finally get a protein.
Basically put, everything and anything in your body is a protein.
Nucleic acids.
Nucleic acids have one job. That's to help make proteins.
Nucleic acids form DNA and RNA.
DNA is the blueprint for everything and anything in your body.
RNA acts like a messenger.
Need a new skin cell due to bleeding? RNA transfers info from the DNA so that the skin cell can be made. The building blocks for DNA and RNA come from the food we eat, such as the cheeseburger.
All of which makes life possible. This is just a brief snapshot of the importance of carbon. Boom! Science accomplished.